Hello everyone, so today we are going to discuss a topic of redox reactions class 11 and the topic name is Stock notation. Okay, and this topic is like very easy, it's not at all difficult. Certain things we all should keep in mind when we are finding out the Stock notations, right? The first thing that we have to do is we will be getting a formula of a particular compound. Okay, from that formula we are supposed to find out the metal, right? And most probably this metal will be a transition metal. Transition metal means that it will be from the D block. Okay, so mostly this metal is a transition metal. This is the first thing, that from the given formula we are supposed to find out the metal, and the metal is generally a transition metal. After we have found that what the transition metal is, we are supposed to find out the oxidation number of that particular metal. So once we find out the oxidation number, we have to write that oxidation number in Roman numerals. Okay, so suppose that is 1, so we will write the Roman numeral 1, 2, then Roman numeral 2, then 3, then 4, 5, and so on. Okay, so we have to write that oxidation number in Roman numerals. Then the Roman numeral should be enclosed within parenthesis. Parenthesis means the curved bracket. Okay, and where we have to write this Roman numeral, this Roman numeral should be written after the name of that metal. Okay, so we are supposed to write this Roman numeral right after the name of that metal. So these are certain rules that we have to follow for Stock notation. I am saying the rules once again. So first we'll be given a formula. From the formula we are supposed to find the metal, and that metal will mostly be a transition metal, right? Then in the second step we are supposed to find the oxidation number of that metal. In the third step we have to write that oxidation number in the Roman numeral. If that comes out to be 1, the oxidation number 1, then Roman numeral 1, if 2, then 2, 3, 4, and so on. And the Roman numerals should be enclosed within parenthesis after the symbol or the name of the element. Okay, this is our fourth step, that the Roman numeral will always come after the name of that element. Suppose we are given a formula like this, MnO2. Okay, suppose we are given this, so we all can see that this is the metal in this case. So we are we have identified our metal, so our step number 1 is done. We have found the metal, and in this case it is manganese. In the second step then we have to find the oxidation number. So X will be for Mn, and plus 2 oxygen, and oxidation number of 1 oxygen is -2. It is equal to 0 because it's a neutral molecule. We'll do the calculation. X minus 4 is equal to 0, and X comes out to be plus 4. So we are done with the second step. We have found the oxidation number, that is plus 4. In the third one, we have to write that oxidation number in Roman numeral. So what is the Roman numeral of 4? This is 1V. We have converted it. And now we have to write this oxidation number after the metal and in Roman numerals within parentheses. So how will I write this? I will write the Stock notation of this as MN4O2. Very simple. So I have written it MN4O2. Okay, let us take another example. Suppose the second example is let it be Fe2O3. Okay, so in this case the metal is Fe, and we are supposed to then follow the steps, find out the metal. We have done that. Now oxidation number. So we have to find the oxidation number of Fe, but total 2 are given. So it will be 2x plus 3 oxygen, oxidation number of 1 oxygen is -2, it is equal to 0. 2x minus 6 is equal to 0. 2x is equal to 6, and x is equal to 6/2, which is equal to 3. So we are done with the second step. We have found the oxidation number of that metal. Now in the third, we have to write the oxidation number in Roman numeral. So what is the Roman numeral for 3? It is this within the parenthesis. And in the fourth step now, the last step, we have to write this Roman numeral or the oxidation number after the name of the metal. So what will be the Stock notation for this now? It will be Fe3O3. This is how we write it. So this is the Stock notation for Fe2O3. In the same way, we can take any other case also. Like suppose I take HAUCl4. Okay. So what is the metal in this case? It is Au. Now I will suppose it to be X. This is plus 1. This is 4 chlorine and oxidation number of chlorine is minus 1. So let us all start. This is 1 plus x plus 4 into minus 1 is equal to 0. 1 plus x minus 4 is equal to 0. X is equal to 4 minus 1 and x is equal to 3. So how will I write the Stock notation of it? 3 will be written as this. In the Roman within the parenthesis. So now my Stock notation becomes HAU3 in the Roman and Cl4. This is how we write it. Okay. Now let this be your homework and try and find the Stock notation of the metal in this case, and you can put in your answer in the comment section. So that's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.